Let's break this down. If you are for this because it's just about trade, let's be clear. If it's just on trade, the measure from the administration, how much will we gain if this goes through from trade? Their measure is that it would not be 1%, it wouldn't even be 0.5% of GDP. The statistical discrepancy in how we measure GDP is bigger than the gain that they're claiming you're going to get from trade. So let me break this down into simple English. That means you could not tell that it happened. That's what this is going to get you. The benefit is something I couldn't even tell you it happened. That's how small this is. So you go, well, if it's so small, I don't even know it happened. Why are we lobbying so we can get something we don't even know it happened? Here's why. Because this is not about trade. So why are we doing all this if it's about nothing? Because this rewrites corporate rules. Now, when they say that, oh, we care about labor, understand what the ISDS really does, because what this does is it says that corporate rules and corporate protection of investment is international. So that my corporate laws must go with me when I go. But notice, no other law goes with them. No environmental law, no labor law, no human rights law, no other law goes with them. Just the law that protects their investment. This is not about free trade, because if it's free, then you don't have protections. Free is, let's not have protections. But this is to protect one group and no other group. Let's understand what is unique about the ISDS. There is no, absolutely, positively, no international tribunal that the United States law recognizes. If you violate human rights, like a Saddam Hussein, you go to the International Human Rights Tribunal. The United States does not recognize that tribunal. You cannot bring an American citizen to that tribunal. If an American soldier commits a war act, you cannot take them to an international tribunal. We do not recognize that tribunal. We have our constitution with our laws and our representatives who pass the law, and we have our court, the United States Supreme Court, that is supreme in interpreting our laws, and if you want to sue one of us, then you must go through that court system. We don't care about international human rights. We don't care about international war crimes. None of that. We don't recognize it. Because the United States Constitution is inviolate, and the United States Supreme Court is the sole and only interpreter of United States law. Except if you're a corporation. Then it's not that you have to appeal to the United States Supreme Court. You get your own court. Your own personal court. Do I get a court? No! Because I don't have 600 lobbyists sitting in a secret room negotiating protections for me. I don't have lobbyists to pay Congress to pass guarantees to protect me. I don't have that. This can't be. This is the biggest crony capitalist type of document that could exist. It is confusing because after you read 300 pages, your eyes glaze over and you cannot see all the little ornaments stuck in these agreements, each one to write a protection for one of those 600 lobbies. Each one of them gets one little sentence and you go, if this is a free trade agreement, why is there this special language about the patent of a drug that's invented before 1996, but it goes on longer? And he's going, that's one company got their gift, got their crony capitalism gift to protect them. And then they got a court to back it up. This is why labor stands against this. This must be done democratically. This must be done out in the open. It can't be that 600 corporate lobbyists can read something you can't read. Congressman Allison can't read it. Congresswoman DeLorio can't read it. But 600 corporate lobbyists can read it. The 600 corporate lobbyists are going to vote on it. They're going to spend all their money trying to bribe votes. But they don't get to vote on it. But the people we have to vote on it can't read it. You know it smells. It can't be about trade because you don't get anything from the trade. It has to be about the something else. And the something else is the corporate greed that robs American workers.